So, yes, actually, yes, indeed. My talk is about industry applications from space and using, of course, as well Copernicus data. So we use many Copernicus data for our services. The raw data of the Sentinel satellites are of a very important value. We use this, of course, in integration with other data resources and also commercial satellite data. In this presentation, next slide. So I'm presenting you the topics essentially of my colleagues and who are working in the Asia and Pacific sector. So with this, I introduce my colleagues, Mr. Fajar Adi. We recently launched the EirMap office in Indonesia, and my colleague, Dr. Vettel from Australia, his office, which exists there since several years already. The headquarters of EirMap is located in Germany, as you correctly said, Rainer, before. So here in the Lakes District around Munich. So we focus on products in the aquatic sector, which have a distinct value for agencies and industries. So like water depths, shallow water depths, water quality, seafloor, but also high demands on quality to really deliver value to the clients and the agency. So we are serving to engineering companies, governments, and academia, both with data services, but as well with technology. So in this you will see later, then also with software for ground segments or for direct for client, for the agencies and also larger industries to do their own measurements just with the satellite software, which is already connected then to the satellite data archive. So the sector is aquatic sector. There are different applications that we touch and that we serve to when it comes to environmental impact assessments before you start building infrastructures, for example, environmental monitoring, if you have this in place for the hydropower sector, inland water sector, but many in the coastal areas. And I will focus this talk more on the maritime side, on navigation side. There are important aspects still nowadays to, for example, measure the water depths in the shallow water areas. And there are many regions around the globe and also in Asia, there are many areas where we can increase and actually increase safety than using the satellite technology, satellite-based high-resolution depths. And as outlined, well, there was a reference before to the tsunami 2004. And actually this tsunami also drove us at that time, still at the German Aerospace Center, and then 2 years later with the launch of the company to develop the remote sensing-based bathymetry from hyper and multispectral airborne sensors to satellite sensors. So we applied this actually first time for the regions in Asia after the tsunami happened in the frame of the larger tsunami project. And you see here large-scale bathymetry assimilated with land and deep water, which we deliver nowadays to different clients than for example, for tsunami modeling, for proper tsunami modeling in large scale areas. But I would like to go next to rather high resolution mapping where satellite derived bathymetry nowadays entered already into the charts to concretely fill gaps in charts like we did on quite large scale for the New Zealand Hydrographic Office LHINs for under contracted by UKHO in different regions like Tuvalu and also the software to train the hydrographic offices and the defense agencies in Indonesia and Australia, for example, to produce on their own those bathymetry maps that they need to increase safety in their waters. The benefits are quite clear. There is the full coverage on remote areas with the satellites in different resolutions. So with Sentinels up to 10-meter resolutions and then with the very commercial high-resolution satellites in 1 to 2 meter resolution. It's excellent to capture those many uncharted features, and it's also excellent to reduce risk by this at a much lower cost than you usually would do if you only use LiDAR or the in situ mapping capabilities. It's much more rapid as well. So there are a number of examples. I will not go to the detail here just to be quicker, but just be aware it is nowadays already on charts and it is used also in much smaller scales to map morphologic changes and bathymetry changes. For example, here in Australia, it's in continuous monitoring since several years and on coast districts for the coastal, for the municipalities here, in this case contracted by a coast consulting engineer company. Large-scale contributions, that's what we as well, of course, perform from the satellites, both in Europe, in the Caribbean side, and Europe here for the European initiative EMODNET. Those data sets we as well contribute to GEPCO on a larger scale. So I very well appreciate the talk of Karen Wang today on really exchange also these data to on larger scales. And as well, we recently mapped also very large scale Asian regions here, Marshall Islands, Solomon Islands, Kiribati, and so on. These are all quite huge areas. Maybe you remember that also we first time mapped the whole Great Barrier Reef a few years ago. More important, even the same importance has the further development of the accuracy from space and the integration also with very high resolution drone data. I think that's a trend where you can, which we you already apply for industry services. Yeah, coming to the next topic, how to enable organizations to really deliver high quality data to their country in any scale. It might be small water agencies or monitoring themselves with these new tools which are directly connected to the satellite archives. So we recently launched a new portal and capability to do this without installing any software, because the software is already installed on cloud. It is already connected to the satellite data archives. And this makes it easier to use satellites just as a measurement instrument, but in the same time already to integrate this in online portals and exchange, for example, with APIs. You see on the third picture here is Watco X software that we have delivered also for hydrographic offices for own in-house productions, and which we nowadays make available also in the frame of a larger European project through APIs for larger client groups who have demand to control their own and fill gaps with satellite data for their own demand. We are quite active here in capacity building. So we launched the first conference series on satellite drive bathymetry and shallow water mapping in 2018. Just to remind you that many more information is available in the web, and just in the past weeks, we were quite active with SDB Day in Asia and Oceanica. And you will see here also contributions, for example, from Indonesia, from Australia, and from other countries. Last year, Indonesia was very active. You see Admiral Hartro from Poshidrosel in Indonesia. This was more than 400 participants. And we do this kind of engagement also directly for the IHO regional commission meetings also in Asia. We usually participate there and now started with a few weeks ago with the last SDB day to work on best practices guidelines together with all the smaller and also the leading hydrographical agencies. So this includes Indonesia, Australia, NOAA, US, SHOM, and so on. So as a technology leading company, we have to contribute here, and we see as more understanding we have in the community, which kind of best practices and technology is needed to assure data quality to assure fit for purpose data as better it is usually for everybody. That's why we as well contribute in capacity building for UNESCO with the first World Water Quality Atlas, UNEP, nowadays with training in Africa and so on. It was as well mentioned, plastic is a topic, so we love to exchange in this as well, as we are leading an ESA-funded project here and started recently as well initiative activities in Indonesia with river sensors and connecting this with satellites. So again, this, I think it's a good link to Mr. Karen Wang in the talk today. And I would like to quit my talk already. Maybe you have still questions, and please come also back to me and my colleagues directly then afterwards. Thank you very much.